Hello, everyone. My name is Olivia Savage, and I'm the Director of Product Marketing here at Newswire. Welcome to today's Smart Start educational video on digital marketing. Marketing used to be a catch-all term for basically any outgoing messaging about your brand or product, but things have really, really changed in the digital era. So today we're going to take a step back and look at digital marketing as a whole, all of the things that make it up, and how to employ it to reach your business goals. Here today to talk with me about this and more is my colleague, Maria Marhefka. Welcome back, Maria. How are you?
Hi, Olivia. I'm doing great, and I'm excited to talk about one of my personal favorite topics, which is digital marketing.
All right, so let's start with the absolute basics, and let's define what digital marketing really is.
So digital marketing includes all marketing efforts that are carried out through digital and online means to connect companies with their current and potential customers. Examples of digital marketing include, but aren't limited to, content marketing, email marketing, social media marketing, pay-per-click advertising, and search engine optimization.
And if somebody who knew absolutely nothing about digital marketing were to ask you what is the importance of digital marketing, what would you say?
Well, for starters, 4.6 billion people around the world use the internet. And whether people are checking their social media channels, conducting searches of their own, or making a purchase, consumers are spending a considerable amount of time online. And that's why digital marketing is an important piece of any company, no matter their industry or the size of their company, should really place an emphasis on their advertising and marketing strategy. Now, in addition to meeting your target audience where they are, digital marketing can offer significant return on investment, or ROI, when campaigns are optimized properly. Now, for example, traditional forms of marketing like a radio advertisement or maybe a billboard along the highway, they can still be effective for some companies and their audiences, but you know, digital campaigns such as email marketing, you know, having a presence on social media, deploying pay-per-click advertising, they're also, you know, an additional way and an affordable way that you can send your message directly to the people that matter most, which is your target audience, at a fraction of the cost sometimes. Another added benefit of digital marketing is that it provides companies invaluable insights regarding the efficiency of their campaigns. So that really helps you, you know, measure a campaign's effectiveness, and it helps you carefully track, you know, the amount of money that you're spending compared to the results that you've earned. And that is an important kind of checks and balances to really keep in mind, is you want to make sure that the money you're spending, you're getting that in return and then some.
That is so true. If you've ever employed something like a billboard or even just thought about how that works when it comes to marketing, you can measure the traffic going on the road that goes by the billboard every day, and you can kind of see what other people have seen as far as their results from using a billboard and seeing whether or not that increases sales, like in a certain zip code. But there's no real way to measure how many people are actually reading it, understanding what it is, and then taking action based on that billboard. Whereas with digital media, somebody visits a website, somebody clicks on a link, somebody looks at an ad, all of that information about how many people are actually seeing it and how well it's performing is available to you. And that is one of the things that makes digital marketing so special. So, what are some of the pieces of advice that you might give to somebody who's first starting out with a digital marketing campaign?
First step when developing a digital marketing strategy is you want to highlight what exactly it is that you're trying to accomplish. Are you trying to build brand awareness? Are you trying to generate more leads, increase your website traffic, maybe build an email list? No matter what your goal is or your goals are, write them down. And we suggest choosing three to start and then kind of mapping out the specific steps that you'll need to take in order to accomplish them. Now from there, you have to do your due diligence in order to understand who makes up your target audience. This means that you're going to uncover a lot of information, you know, the demographics, their interests, their pain points, you know, what questions are they asking, and much more. And when you know who you're talking to, you'll have a better understanding of how to communicate with them, and which will really help you deliver the right message to the right audience at the right time. Now, think of digital marketing like you would a GPS. Once you've set your destination, which would be your goals, you can then lean on your digital marketing strategy to get you from point A to point B. Of course, along the way, there will probably be detours, maybe some roadblocks. You'll have to reroute your course. But having a defined goal, kind of acting as your North Star and your final destination, will help you stay the course and reach that final destination that you've set for yourself.
Excellent advice. Okay, so let's say somebody is starting out building a strategy, and we want to help them avoid some of the pitfalls that come with that territory. So what are some things to avoid?
The first mistake that I suggest that you try to avoid at all costs is being impatient. Now, business owners, they're human. We're all human beings, and sometimes patience isn't our strong suit. We want results to happen overnight, and whenever it comes to business, that's simply not the case. Unfortunately, that rarely happens, so patience is required to really fully understand if a digital marketing strategy is working or not. If the results don't come immediately, don't be alarmed. There are many contributing factors to increase the success of a campaign. You know, they include, and of course, they're not limited to, the time of day that you're posting, maybe the campaign creative, maybe the content that you're, you know, pairing with that, where you're distributing the message, and how much money you're actually putting into paid advertising efforts. There are so many moving pieces when it comes to the overall digital marketing puzzle. What you want to do is you want to give it time to breathe, and then that way you can really, once you've collected that data, adjust accordingly. You know, if something's working, maybe double down. If you see something isn't working quite as well as you thought it would be, make some tweaks and keep finessing what content you're putting out there to improve it or kind of double down on what's working. To that point, the second mistake is that you're ignoring the performance data. Data is really important whenever it comes to digital marketing because, like we said in the last point, that data is really showing you which direction you need to take your campaigns. And of course, there's more data out there. We've talked about this before than we could probably compute in a lifetime. So it's important to pinpoint the data that's relevant to your overarching goals that you set at the beginning of your campaigns. And once you have a clear understanding of the data that you should be paying attention to, it's easier to see what aspects of your digital marketing strategy are working and which are not. You know, there's a kind of ebb and flow of how you should approach your digital marketing efforts. And you want to first analyze, then you adjust, you implement, and then you repeat. The third and final mistake is that you're not seeing the big picture. You know, like I said before, there are many moving pieces whenever it comes to a digital marketing strategy. And if you focus too much on one aspect, you'll lose sight of the others. Therefore, you know, you need to really prioritize which platforms and initiatives matter most to your target audience. And then pay close attention to the data regarding those key demographics. At Newswire, we offer clients a holistic and comprehensive approach to integrated media and marketing communications, and we ensure that their messages across all platforms are uniform and they're impactful, whether it's, you know, email marketing, press release distribution, maybe a social media post, thought leadership content, all these campaigns and more. You want to have a united front. And, you know, investing in the right resources to help you devise and implement a cohesive digital marketing strategy that consistently addresses what your target audience and, you know, journalists in your specific industry are interested in is really going to set your company up for success in the moment and success in the future.
Definitely. And you bring up a lot of really great points about all of these different platforms and different ways to employ a strategy that you might put together. There are a ton of platforms out there that allow you to do self-service digital marketing on platforms like Facebook or LinkedIn, for instance. And that's great that there are all of these tools available to pretty much anybody who would like to start a campaign, but you'll quickly realize that keeping track of all of these different things, measuring their performance, figuring out how much to spend, trying new platforms, seeing which works best, this is all a very complicated web of options available to you, and they're constantly changing. So staying on top of all of those changes and making sure that you are optimizing and spending all of your marketing budget wisely can be really, really difficult. So if you're struggling to keep on top of all of this, you don't have the manpower to really give it the attention it deserves, here at Newswire, we can definitely help. So feel free to drop a comment below. You can find us on social media, or you can visit our website, newswire.com. Thank you so much, Maria, and thank you for watching. Have a great day.